Hi, it's Dan. Welcome back to iGuitar. We have a fantastic bass here for review. It's a Dingwall ABZ 6-string and a very tasty black burst finish. Let's take a look at it straight away. Up at the headstock end, we've got ultra lightweight black hardware tuning keys and the Dingwall logo at the top there. This is straight away you can see a laminate maple neck. Let's flip it over and have a look at the back straight away. There we go. Really nice light maple. It's very lightweight as well. As you heard in the intro, a nice bright tone there. It's fantastic. Lightweight keys. There we go. Flip it back over. Okay. Straight on to the exciting bit. You'll notice that the fretboard, it looks a bit strange. We have got the Novax fan fret system, which allows us and more even tension on the neck between the strings, and also the longer B string makes it sound a lot fuller as well. And it feels ultra comfortable. When I first picked this up, I thought it was going to be a bit more difficult to play, but straight away I felt quite at home with it. So let's move all the way down the neck and just have a look what we've got here. A nice maple fretboard to go with the maple neck. Interestingly, these frets are tiny. These are actually banjo frets, banjo-sized frets. Again, a little departure from the usual sort of medium and jumbo kind of frets that you would have on, say, more standard basses, but this is really nice, really comfortable straight away. I've no reason to even question it. It feels really comfortable. Nice radius on the fretboard as well. It's more rounded than some. It's definitely a nice, comfortable feel on it. Probably a slightly lower radius figure than maybe some of the other six-string basses on the market. I'm just going to flip the bass forward a little bit. Against the maple neck, we've got nice, strong, big black dots there for the markers, which is a nice touch. You're going to see those in the dark easily without needing LEDs or additional lighting or anything like that. Okay, let's move all the way up. Two dots for the 12th fret marking there. 24 fret neck. And interesting, as we move back, talking about the scale length. The scale length for the B string is nigh on 37 inches. And over to the C string, we're looking about 33¼ inches. So a little bit shorter than the standard P bass for, you know, the high strings, but, you know, massive 37 inch scale for the B. So it's got a really good. Still going, the sustain. We could sit there all day and listen to it, I think. Let's move back. Let's have a look at the rest of the bass. Coming up to the end of the fretboard. Comes right into the body. We'll have a look at the joint in a moment as we have a look at the back of the bass. We've got two passive Dingwall pickups here. Up to the back. Nice. Nice big bridge there. Again, I know I bang on about this, but a high mass bridge for as much sustain as you can get off the instrument, and nice clarity to the tone. I like that a lot. This is really interesting. The string is actually sat on, it looks like a couple of screws. So instead of actually having a saddle that you raise up and down with a couple of grub screws, the string is actually sat on top of these screw-like mountings for the saddles. And they're obviously movable backwards and forwards for intonation and the like. Quick release bridge as well, so there's a little slot there. String goes in the back. Let's move down. Okay, three controls. This is very interesting. The bass is passive. No batteries or anything like that to worry about. But fantastically, the tone that you probably heard on the intro, it sounds full straight away. There's probably no need for it at all. Let's have a look at the controls. We have got a passive tone control here. And out at the front, we've got the volume control. And in the middle, we've got a rotary pickup selector, but I like this as well. This is really different. I'm gonna spend a little bit of time on this before we flip the bass over. It's a four-way switch. So instead of with a standard setup, you'd have a three-way with the front pickup on its own, and then the middle would be both pickups, and then the rear bridge position would be on the third setting. The fourth setting is really interesting. Let's have a listen to it, let's go through it. So first setting would go to position number one. This is just the front pickup on its own. Got a nice plummy, almost like a slight P bass character to that. Be great for a bit of slap work. Nice. Let's go on to the next position. Now, this is where it gets interesting. This position is both pickups in series. So we've got them one stacked on top of the other in the circuit, and it's going to give us more middle and a lot more volume. Let's have a listen to that. A little bit of slap too. Okay, let's move straight on to the next position. Position three is both pickups again, but this time in parallel. So we're gonna get that naturally sort of hollowed out sound, a bit more of a scoop, and a slight perceived drop in volume. That'd be the difference between a series and a parallel wiring. Let's have a listen to that. And again, with a little bit of slap on that sound as well, that scoop hollow should work quite nicely. Nice, like that. And then finally, position four, as expected, it's going to be just the bridge pickup on its own. A little bit of a noodle there, and it's got a nice little bite to it. Be great for sailoring, a bit of boost from a pedal or maybe from the amp. That'll sing out really, really nicely in the mix. I think what we'll finally do is we'll just roll around the tone control as well so you can hear that. So we'll go back to, I like the series setting, that's nice and full. I think that's been my favorite so far. We'll just have a look at the tone control. So, all the way off, we're gonna have this nice, more mellow sound. And then I'm going to bring around to about halfway. There we go. And then finally we'll go fully open as well. So there you go, straight away there's actually a range of sounds. Again, this is passive, there's no boost or EQ sort of system preamp going on in here. It's very musical, very, very usable. Let's take a look at the back of the body. There we go. I'm going to go a nice swamp ash body with this black burst around it. And like the really deep joint here between the neck and the body. And another really especially good for all you solo players. I'm going to get up the dusty end of the neck, as they say. A big cutaway there. Bring my hand up. You can see I've got easy access all the way up to the 24th fret. That's absolutely fantastic. I'm going to put some more details into the written review. But for now, thank you for watching. And we'll take a bit more of a look at this Dingwall ABZ.